medical home is all about coordinating care and bringing people together.
A personal relationship with a healing clinician has healing power.
The medical home approach to healthcare, while the terminology might be new to some people, is truly not new at all. It's really the new old-fashioned approach to healthcare.
Medical home is not a noun, it's a verb. It's not a place. It's the way you deliver healthcare.
We've developed viable, sustainable models of team-based care that make it possible for us to address most and even all of your healthcare needs.
We want to make sure that we're all on the same page when we're talking about quality, comprehensive, culturally responsive, family, patient-centered care.
I think that we're on the verge of some real major changes.
The providers in our community are much more accepting now of our medical home approach to healthcare because they understand that they're part of a team.
Learning to work in teams is really hard for health professionals, but I'm seeing over and over again people who get over the curve of learning and who get over the resistance to change like this and feel like they come back, they feel vindicated, come back to why they got in the business of being a health professional in the first place.
The medical home approach is so much more than a clinical experience. It really does take an entire community to deliver this approach.
Colorado wants to be a medical home state, one medical home community at a time. So we have to ask ourselves, well, what does that mean? And that means that a medical home team is more than just the people in the front office and the back office of a clinic. It's the community as a whole and the resources and the richness and the vast wealth of information that exists in the community.
Providers didn't know that they could turn their clients over to perhaps an agency that could help them with housing issues or transportation issues, or you know, maybe it's childcare that they need.
Community-based partnerships are one of the most important ways that a so-called patient-centered medical home can expand to become a neighborhood or a patient-centered health community.
We know that the young people of today are some of the greatest resources of our country and in our state and in our communities. So how do we use that? We're asking that question and the youth are answering.
The providers need to be open to hearing what you have to say, and we need to be open to saying, hey, I have something to say.
I think having medical home is essential for youth because I feel like youth, like us, we like open up more when we know that the person we're talking to actually knows about us.
I think it'd be better for all of us, all youth, to go back and actually ask questions and understand what they're trying to tell you, so then you know what's going on inside you.
The medical home approach is very important to youth because it empowers them to take charge of their own health care.
I think there needs to be support from all angles that affect a person. So if it's, you know, the parents, when you go to the doctor's office, gradually step out of the room and gradually make you fill out your own paperwork.
Kind of like we were when we were younger, except flip-flop. Now I'm getting the news and my mom gets to sit there and play with the cool toys on the wall.
The new old way of delivering health care is more exciting to them. It's because it focuses on the person instead of the issue or the chronic disease.
I was at the dentist and they told me, oh, come back on this certain date, and I put it in a week early on my cell phone, and I walked in there and they're like, you don't have an appointment today. And I was like, oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. And I walked out, I was already at the car, and she came running after me and she's like, you know what, we actually have a cancellation, you can come in right now. And it made me feel like really like happy that they actually cared enough to come outside and find me.
I think it comes back to that relationship with your doctor and having that connection with them and getting to know them also, because the more you tell them, the more they get to know you.
We are cultivating youth involvement in our community by having them at the table and by recognizing that their voice is imperative in this work. It's a cliche to say that youth are our future, but you know, we hope that in our community we're raising up empowered youth and youth that know how to be advocates for themselves.
We need to change the healthcare system. We need to be more involved. We need to, I mean, we are the future. We are gonna be the ones controlling it. We're gonna be the doctors, we're gonna be the patients, and then we're gonna have our kids, and we're gonna be teaching our kids about healthcare. We could change the healthcare system.
The medical home, I think, is very important for everyone to know, because if we don't have any information or if we don't know anything about the healthcare system now, then how can we ever improve it in the future?
One thing it helps to do is come armed with knowledge about who's been taking care of you so far and what parts of that work well and what parts don't work well.
Everyone I've talked to, you know, a lot of them don't know their doctor. Don't go in to see him very often. It's very, you know, impersonal, get in, get out.
I have my ideas about what might be important to a 20-year-old person who's basically healthy about their prevention needs, but sometimes that's completely different from what they say is important. And figuring out ways to learn what's important and try ideas about how to get to that is a whole new world in personal health care that we are just beginning to see come over the horizon.
Providers are no longer scary authoritative people in white lab coats that talk to you as though you were just a number.
If our generation, you know, gets to the point with medical home where we feel really comfortable going to the doctors, we feel comfortable asking questions, we know what's going on with our own bodies, obviously we're gonna pass that on to our children.
It's just as important to have a guidance counselor to help you make sure you're getting all your high school classes under control and which colleges you're gonna apply to and how to register for the SAT or the ACT. Having a medical home is your guidance counselor for your healthcare.
This is the ultimate independence, is dealing with yourself. Like, this is you. You have to do it.
I hear all the time from patients and also from some providers that this is not realistic. You can't do this. Doctors are too busy, their schedules are too crowded, there's too much to do already. How are you going to add all of the things necessary to build a so-called patient-centered medical home? Well, it turns out that the physicians who are most resistant to this idea are those who are mostly working in isolation, who haven't come to terms with the value of team-based care.
Something has to change. And I believe that healthcare reform, in whatever way it's going to come at us, will include this patient-centered, family-centered approach to healthcare that we call medical home.
We need to be there for you, not you there for us.
We don't wonder what the best way to do this is anymore. We now know.